receive 100,000 naira a month. Naturally speaking, the first thing you should do is God must have his own part. The least, according to scripture, is 10% or even more should be given unto the Lord. The minute you begin to take what belongs to God and you take it to yourself, you are under a curse, whether you know it or not. You are taking from God, and you are stealing from Baba. Praise God. If you steal from federal government, what will they do to you? They will chain you now. But if you steal from God, don't you know that you are under a curse? How can you steal from the creator of heaven and earth? So the first thing is that I'm giving you a planning process. Take 10% away. Always have it at the back of your mind. Or more. I don't do 10%. I don't even do 20%. I don't even do 30%. God is too big for me now. God has been doing good things for me. Why would I be doing God's small small money? Those money, may I see that it's too small for God. That's how I deal with my own God. My God is too big to be receiving those things. Praise God. You give what belongs to God. The Bible says, give what belongs to Caesar to Caesar. Then give what belongs to God to God. After you have done that, let's say you are taking 10%. What do you have left with you? 90%. The 90%, then you should not begin to think, at least another 10% or 5% should go out. At least, you should have 5% for your parents. You know, I used to laugh. Many people don't know the mystery of parental blessing. You see, your parents, they might not be spiritual, though. If they like, they might not know what you know. They might not be too holy. Let me use that word, like maybe you are holy. But see, they have blessing in their house. If they say you are blessed, you will be blessed. And if they say you are cursed, by virtue of something you did that is wrong, though, because not all causes will work. Praise God. It's only the one that have legal backing. If you work, if you come for your parents every month and you honor them, even if your parents don't say you are blessed, God will bless you. Because we are living in a generation. I'm not telling you what I don't practice. Anything I'm telling you, just know it's what I'm practicing. We live in a generation where people cannot even honor their parents. How can your parents be suffering and then you are enjoying? No matter how much you are receiving, whether you are receiving 5 naira, at least take it to cover and give to your parents. You will not just get all the blessing by pastor, bless me. Pastor, bless me now. Bless me, pastor. Pastor, bless me. No! The Bible says, honor your mother, that it may be well with you, that I will bring you, that your days will be long. Listen to me. Your father and your mother has different. You have what you call spiritual father, you have earthly father, right? And even your pastor serves as a spiritual father. Your earthly father, the ones in the village, then you know the third father you have a heavenly father. When the Bible says honor your father and your mother, did it tell you anyone here? It only told you father and mother. Anybody that stands as father and mother in your life must be honored. And when you honor them, you will get the blessing. Why do you think that young people die today? Because they don't honor and respect their father. So their days will be cut short of years. That is why young people die so much in this our day. Have you watched it very well? Gone too soon, 20 years, 40 years, 30 years. Check them very well. You will realize that the way they used to even, either their spiritual father, their earthly father, they don't have regards for them. You know why? Because when you have somebody that is speaking upon your life, there are some certain things that will be breaking loose. Praise God. What did I say? Even if it's 5%.